What's up, guys? We are back with a suspect test lettering. Actually, the first suspect test lettering. This account is kind of low. I'm 3-0. I just made a new team and I wanted to test it. I've been lettering on multiple accounts with friends and like some accounts on my own, and I don't want to ruin my like recording on the other account, so I will just test this account lower letter. Also, low letter isn't really like people are decent on a low letter. I mean, this guy has a low ladder team, but yesterday I was playing low ladder and the ladder was only till like 1350. So you get like really good players even low ladder. I mean, now it's a bit different, I think, because the ladder is a bit higher. I think it goes to 1500 now. But still, like, I think we will face good players, and if I win this, like, if we go just a little bit higher. So we have a Scarf and a Heligo, which I wanted to try for really long. We have HP Fire and T-Spikes. This set is a bit, like, I don't know, it's a bit weird. I'm just gonna test it for now. We have standard Landris. To check Zardex, opposing Landris. We got Nature's Madness, Taunt, Tapu Koko to beat Chansey, or to chip at Chansey. And we got Sorbus Tangros to check Ash, Gren. But let's just get a game. I will lead with my Leftovers Volcanion, which I actually built this team around. Because people like don't pack much for Volcanion. And I will just lead over Landris here before I waste too much time. Most people only have Tapu Fini as a switch in for Volcanion, and I have Sludge Wave on that, so that's not even that good. I can go to Spadef Drill here, which is my spinner. I put Toxic on Drill and Rocks on Lando. First I had Rocks on Drill, I added the Lando later on. And I changed it. I put Toxic on Drill. What is Toxic on Drill for? I guess it's for defensive Lando that wants to switch in, yeah. And like, I'm still thinking about the team I just built it. Like, some people made suggestions. We were really weak to Volcarona and Zardwai, so I added like Scarf and Heligo as last one. We are kind of weak to Metagross, but we can play around that. We can pivot. We can go like, if they predict our Landris, we can just go into Volcanion on the Ice Punch. And I just calced Fire Blast Oko's Mega Metagross from Volcanion, unless I like messed up the calc. Okay, I think that's modest them, because they did. That did 500 million, so I'm not sure how I feel about this. This thing is a big threat. I will just get damage here with a knockoff, and then I think I can go from Drill into Nihiligo seems like a decent pivot. I mean, Drill lives a focus blast, but do I need Drill healthy for anything? Honestly, I don't need Drill for much. I can just go for Earthquake and kill this. I know I live a focus. Okay, he's modest, I forgot. Okay, that was a poor play on my part. I thought I ate that up. I will just go into Heligo and click that Power Gem. He has a Jirachi, which is the problem, yeah. That was awful playing on my part, good god. That has to be modest then. Okay, he sexed it, nice. We get a Beast Boost. That sucks to start off the live like that. I saw Drill lose that for sure. Since I run like a lot of Spadef. Max Spadef, but not max HP. We run enough speed for defensive Lando. This Jirachi is probably offensive if you didn't bring it hard in, but this is just a free Volcanion. Yeah, it just goes for Iron Head, that does 5. And I can go for Fire Blast here. As my man Padlock joined, I don't know why he would protect. I guess to scout if I'm specs. But yeah, I'm just gonna Fire Blast again. I don't care if he goes to Golem Alola. That takes 5 million. That crit doesn't matter. I outspeed him unless he's Scarf. I will just go for Off Power here, not risking a miss. And that boy just disconnected. Okay, nice. Let's just get another one. I hope we will face good opponent. I mean, he didn't time out yet, still has a minute to reconnect, but I don't think that boy is coming back. So let me just grab another one. Okay, this guy also has a weird team, but he has some serious like kind of threats in Greninja. Probably think Greninja is actually a really stupid mon. I have to hope that it doesn't have like something to hit my Volcanion. I can pivot around it, but like, till I found out it's set, it might just weaken my team a lot. So I don't know if that would be Zarya or X. Could be both. You don't really need Tyranitar if you want to run Zarya in Sun and Moon. Latias are not common at the moment. You see Latias sometimes because it has like Z-Memento now. Or like that Z-Thunderbolt thing. Gigavolt Havoc is nice for Skarmory and stuff. And for Tapu Fini, obviously. Volcanion is a nice lead if he doesn't lead at Nidoking. Nidoking is a huge threat, so I should lead something that... Oh god, I don't have anything for the Nidoking. God, I'm so weak to Nidoking. I will just leave with Landorus, and if he leads with Nidoking, he should scout if I'm Scarf. Okay, this thing could belly drum up and like ruin my day. But I will just get rocks up, because he has Volcarona and Zard, which I like. Potential threats. Volcarona gets checked pretty well by Nihiligo. The main threat is like the Nidoking. I didn't think about Nidoking at all when I built this. It's funny, I have the avatar that ABR used in SPL or uses all the time. And ABR used Nidoking, right, in SPL. And now I'm facing Nidoking, it's probably gonna blow me away. We see if the other guy timed out. Yeah, the other guy timed out. And okay, oh god, what? Z Hypnosis? Who hits X button the counter? Oh, he gets a speed boost now, so that speeds my Volcanion too. That sucks. So now he's probably gonna go for Belly Drum or something along those lines. Wait, I don't know if this thing has Aqua Jet. I actually don't know. I will check really quick. It doesn't learn Aqua Jet. Okay, it's okay. It's not the biggest threat then. I mean, this Landorus honestly doesn't do much, so I'll just try to wake up here. As I don't wake up. Now I want to save it. I want to save it now because it's sleep fodder-ish. Yeah, fighting move is gonna blow my Volcanion away, so I'm not sure how I'm gonna play around this Poliwrath. Probably just sack something. The thing is, what do I sack? Since Landorus doesn't do much, maybe I should just sack my Landorus and then. Oh god, I don't have T-Bolt on my Nihiligo. I have to have the Sludge. I have to hope that Sludge Wave kills him. Tangrowth is nice for his Greninja if he doesn't have Gunk Shot. This Volcanion is nice if his Greninja is Protein. So yeah, I don't know why I even switched the Landorus out. Landorus is the sack here. I mean, I wanted to keep Landorus if that's a potential ZX, but I'll have to play around that. The thing is, now I got more chip damage, so Sludge Wave will kill him for sure. So I will just U-turn in case he like misclicked or something. Power Gem should kill. Nidoking comes in afterwards anyway. I'm just gonna Sludge Wave. Nidoking is gonna ruin my day. I really don't know what I have for Nidoking. I have nothing. I have the X button for Nidoking. Yeah, there it is. I need this while Corona 6-0s me, so I'm gonna go Tangrowth here on the Earth Power. Earthquake, he's physical. And he's... Oh, he's live up physical, okay. I was about to say, why did he took recoil? Earthquake doesn't get boosted by Sheer Force, that's why. So Poison Jab will just blow me away here. But I don't have switching, so I like have to stay in. Oh, he only has Ice Punch. Nice. But the thing is, yeah. Now I can revenge him with Nihiligo, that's okay. But good god, this guy with the low ladder threats, 5 punch, Ice Punch. If he had Poison Jab, it would have killed me. Just Tapu Koko doesn't have a move to kill him. Oh, it's just U-turn, so I can pivot versus ground types versus like Gastrodon. Marowak, stuff like that. Was Landorus. Yeah, no, Heligo's the only play, and I have to click, I think, Power Gem. Let me cog real quick to make sure that that kills. Yeah, Power Gem does 26 minimum. So that should pick him off. And we got a Beast Boost. But how much does Sludge Wave do? Sludge Wave wouldn't have killed. Yeah, that's the only reason. I'm not sure why he would go to Ninja. Maybe he's Sash, or maybe he lives one. Let me cut that. Power Gem is a roll. It's about 50-50, like, that it killed. So I don't want to risk that. I feel like I can go to Volcanion here on a water move. I need this Nihilic of 100%. Goes for Water Shuriken, so he was probably Specs. That wouldn't have killed me unless he got, like, a lot of hits. I don't think that would have killed me. I can just click. He cannot touch me here. I assume he's this choice set. So what would he go out into here? I feel like Nihiligo is a really good play here. Just double out into Nihiligo as he stays into Dark Pulse me. So he's not choiced. Okay, that didn't work out as planned. Why would you... What is he in? He's not choiced. He's not Life Orb, is it like Z-Move, Ash Greninja? I'm gonna just go for Sludge Wave. I don't know how to predict this low ladder type of guy. No flinch few. Okay, that did nothing. What the fuck? Wait, how the fuck did that not... I'm modest Volcanion. What is wrong with my Eevee spreads? What the flying fuck? I'm modest max special attack. Why did I do 5? Is this some Assault Vest Greninja shit? Or some HP invested? I honestly don't know. But Volcanion is only mainly needed for this Greninja, so... I guess I have to sack it. And now I gave him the Battle Bond, which is really bad, but since he's not Specs, Goku should live that, and we just go for T-Bolt. This Magnet type of Coco. Yeah, that doesn't do that much. I mean, it does a lot still, because Ash Greninja is stupid. It gets the form, but... that was my fault. I didn't hit a good tech damage for no reason. I thought he would switch there for sure. Minor Heligo just wins with Power Gem. If I get a Beast Boost to kill this, so I will just, like, get chip on this. I mean, Nation's Madness was done around the same. So let me calculate real quick how much... Sludge Wave does. Power Gem. Sludge Wave would kill. Okay, Power Gem does 50 at minimum, so now Heligo should just sweep this. Should just win this game. Unless he's running some weird HP invested spread. Nice. Now Heligo coming through. Like, I never really used Nihiligo. I only used the Sash set once in pre-bank, and it was really boring, and he just forfeits. That's a bit annoying. I wanted to sweep with my Beast Boost, but yeah. We will get one more for sure. That Nidoking was scary, good god. As we face, like, we're facing a lot of weird teams. Configurus. Mance is scary with Z-Move Fly. We have, gotta watch out that I keep my Landorus healthy for that. I feel like Drill is a decent lead here. Actually, I don't have Frogs on Drill. What would he lead? If I was him, I would leave with Rotom probably, so... Tangrowth should be a decent lead overall. Yeah, exactly, I would leave with Rotom if I was him. And I don't have HPH, which sucks, because he can just Volt Switch out into his Mance. So I would probably just click... Knockoff, but if he Volt Switch into Mance and he Z-Move, that doesn't, like, help me at all. If he stays in here, I'm gonna get mad. You should never stay in here, because I could Leaf Storm you. Maybe I should Leaf Storm him. Okay, that's my fault for expecting anything. Oh, I have a Choice Scarf Tangrowth, which sucks. And I'm locked into Knockoff. And he burns me, I don't know. Yeah, I shouldn't have stayed in. Let me just go into my Drill now. God, I'm getting played by low ladder kids. Why am I so bad sometimes? Yeah, he obviously had no reason, like, I thought he would Vault Switch, but Will-O-Wisp was a fine play. Like, worst case, he goes for Hydro Pump, Drill Lifts this anyway, but I think he's gonna Vault or, like, Hard Switch here. If he Wisps again, good play, I guess. He got me. As he, yeah, goes for Vault Switch, and I think Earthquake is fine here. I want a Toxic really bad because he has a Tangrowth. Like, really badly, but I can just Toxic next turn. Oh, since he's offensive, he's probably max speed. So yeah, it speeds me. So let's just pivot around a bit. I don't think I can pivot around. Let me calc if I live a Hydro Pump. Yeah, I should live a Hydro Pump on this. I don't see another pivot play I can make, so I'm just gonna Earthquake. Cofagorus comes out, takes nothing. I feel like Toxicing this is fine. My Drill's probably gonna get Wisp, which is annoying. Maybe I should just go into Volcanion here. Okay, it's too late. I want to cancel. Yeah, that was my fault. I'm gonna get really mad now. I should have gone to Volcanion there. That was so obvious. Good god, how obvious was this? Like, man, I mean, the Toxic on this is really nice, but. Oh, yet again, by the way, I'm using another team without a Mega and without a Z-move. I don't know why, but I never have space to fit those on. I had, like, Z-move on Coco first, a little, like, Guardian of Alola, but I think, like, I changed it to Magnet. And we were thinking Megathizer on the last slot to check Metagross, but we'll just have to pivot around Metagross because Nihiligo's needed to check Volcarona's out. Why? Lando's needed to check opposing Lando and Mens and stuff like that. Yeah, we'll just fire off Steam Eruptions here. Does a good chunk as he has Toxic. Okay, okay. I will just Sludge Wave. That should kill from Surfing. It's resisted, I think, but it should still kill. And I don't want him to get a free switch into Rotom. Exactly, exactly. That we do some nice damage to that. And yeah, okay, nice. You had speed, so it wasn't max speed for some reason. I mean, I'm modest max speed on this, but Rotom should still outspeed me if it was Timmy. So Tapu Koko comes in. If you see Brave Bird, good on him, good on him. But I'm gonna. Oh god, I forgot my Tangrowth lost its Assault Vest. I completely forgot. So the only thing I can do is like Leaf Storm. Now Earthquake isn't gonna do shit. He should just go Mens. Yeah, I mean, he doesn't know if I have HP. Or anything. Oh, he's not Moxie. That's really nice to see. Yeah, but like you see these gimmicks on the ladder. I mean, Trick is not a gimmick, but you don't see Trick Rotom that often, and this Cofagorus, this is not something you see in the highlight. Okay, here's Fire Blast. Is he completely special? Oh, he's life up. Okay, okay, I cannot stay in then. He just forfeits, I don't know why. He still had a chance, but I just needed some damage on his Drill on Scarf and Heligo would clean up again. So yeah, I would have switched my Landers out so I can still check his Drill. I would have probably gone here and do Tapu Koko on a Draco or Hydro Pump. Or just sack off my Tangrowth. Since it's crippled, my Tangrowth doesn't do much. But yeah, since he forfeits, we will just get another one. It's 90 minutes, okay. And we get this guy. Oh god, I think this guy's German and I think he knows me. I think he's a triad. Let me check his rank. So I have to weaken Magearna and Garchomp to sweep with Nihiligo this game. There's probably Z-move Gyarados. Actually, this guy doesn't have the best win-loss ratio. Not sure if that is the guy that I was thinking of. I thought it was a German guy. So that's either Z-move or Mega Gyarados, right? Could also be like Z-move Lando. Rocks Jump, could be Scarf Jump. Let me just think. I don't think Coco is a good lead because he has Tangrowth, Lando, and Chomp, which all annoy me. Landers is an okay lead because it beats. It leads off decently versus these two and kind of decently versus Magearna because I can threaten him with potential max attack Earthquake. So I would just leave him my Landers. Rocks are really nice this game because he has that Gyarados, so I will just get up Rocks. I don't care if he HP ices me. Okay, he does the same, and I will just HP ice now. As he U-turns out, takes some chip. And he goes Tangrowth. Okay, we will see if his AV or Fizz Death. That looks to be Assault Vest. That does absolutely nothing, and we can U-turn out here into what? Into Excadrill to get the spin off. I gotta be careful though. I don't have Wish Pass. I wanna Wish Pass again. I use that strategy a lot. So Excadrill doesn't get like whittled. I gotta keep my Volcanion for that ninja. Yeah, I'm just gonna go for Toxic. It's either gonna hit his Tangrowth or his Landorus. As I lift that Earthquake, now I'm gonna spin, I think. Because I don't spin on anything else. I should lift this. Oh, I died to Helmet. Okay, that sucks a lot. I should have double Toxic. I thought Helmet only does 14% or 13. Does it do 16? I didn't know that there's 16. That was really bad then. I should have double Toxic. Since I don't have HPIs on this Nahiligo, I'm just put in a back position now. I'm forced into Volcanion. It's the only thing that can kill this. Yeah, let's just go for Steam Eruption. We hit, amazing. I mean, it would be better if I didn't die there and if I got rocks off, because, yeah. If I got rocks off, I would feel really nice about this. Now I just... It's actually kind of scary now. But yeah, let's just go hard Landorus. I don't see how else I can switch into this charm. Like, that's my main answer. Since we have HP eyes, I mean, Earthquake breaks us up too, but... Sub SD. Just HP eyes. Wait, I mine a special attack nature on this Landorus, I just realized. That still killed? Wow. I didn't think that would kill. I think I mine a special attack. I think mine speed is a bit better to do more damage, so I'm gonna change it to that. Because you want slow U-turns anyway, so I think mine speed nature is fine. I would U-turn out on this as he Drang Dances, and Scarfner Hilligo should come in here for free. As it outspeeds Gera at plus one, and I can just click Power Gem. Oh god, if he's Mega Gyarados. I don't think Sludge Wave kills. I have to bank on him being. Oh, he's Mega. Fuck. Yeah, I think I just lose then. Oh, that did nothing. Yeah, I didn't think this through. I could have gone like. Could have gone into my Tangrowth, but I thought he was the Zemo Fly. That's why I didn't go into my Tangrowth. Like, obviously, that's why I didn't go to Tangrowth. Would be nice to have Giga Drain on Tangrowth, but we don't have that, so we will just have to rely on hitting a Leaf Storm here. That's the only way to revenge this. This is actually kind of looking bad. I didn't play my Drill Optimal, like, honestly. But I thought I would get the spin-off there. I honestly didn't know that Helmet was 16. Maybe Data Rocky Helmet. It loses 1/6 max of its HP, okay. I want to keep this for his Greninja if it doesn't have Gunk. I think Volcanion is the play here. Or he doubles into Greninja. So we will find out if he's like... If he specs, he might kill me. He's... Okay, I would have lived that, but that sucks for him. But since he turns into Poison type... I know why he's complaining, we are playing Pokemon, your move is 80% accuracy. I know Hex sucks, but complaining doesn't help you. I also didn't complain when Pokemon like crit me 3 times. This guy said no, I lost GG, like that would've Twit killed me maybe, but like... I don't think it matters that much, like... It's a bit annoying for him, I get it, but... I got it, like it's really annoying for him. I just misplayed this a bit. Like, I hate Sun and Moon because, I mean, I like Sun and Moon better than Auras, but what I hate about Sun and Moon is that it's unpredictable because so many Z-moves, random Z-moves, you cannot predict everything. I thought he would be Z-move Gyarados because that set is honestly better than Mega Gyarados, but then he was Mega Gyarados that I just lost my Nihiligo, that was like my check to outspeed Scarf Greninja. Not Scarf Greninja, that was my check to outspeed Greninja. Let's just hit this file. That's amazing. We can hit our moves. I don't care. This guy like complained. Hex happens. That's Pokemon. I lose like some games to Hex too. I had to make a new alt yesterday because I got Hex. I think, yeah. Just hit this. We don't miss. Oh, he's Scarf Magearna. What the fuck? Oh, he's just Max Speed Magearna. He doesn't have to be Scarf. So this is just bad. I think we lose now. No, we don't lose, We just go Tangrowth here. Actually, we do lose. I think we do lose now. Oh, he shift gears up, now he outspeeds my Coco. Why is this so close? Oh yeah, we lose this, yeah. Yeah, I don't know what this guy said he lost. Wow, that's really sad. Choked this away, I think. Yeah, I just hate Sun and Moon, like, you cannot predict everything. My team's probably not good either, but whatever, let's just say GG and forfeit. I will not cut this out, I'm not MV, we keep the losses in. We get one more though, I'm not ending up on... And we get stall, and I will make... I will do everything in my... that is possible to beat this scum of stall. Of a stall faggot. He doesn't have that good of a win loss. Let me check again. Yeah, if I lose to this guy, my career is over. I have to win this. The last game was honestly not well played by me, but it. I didn't even think about Shifky Magina when I built this team. All like, there are so many threats, and I built this team in like 6 minutes. Let me just concentrate better now. Volcanion does a lot if I can get rid of the Chansey. Which is what my Tapu Koko set is supposed to do, so let's lead with this. Fire off of Nature's Madness. Predicting the Chansey. If he stays in here, that's not a play. Like, if he stays in here, he's just bad and I'm gonna get really mad. Honestly, stall players are... Like, his team doesn't look good. Looks like he's just stuck in Auras and we miss turn 1. Thank you, stall faggot. Thank you. Let me just Nature's Madness again. Why do you... And he has Toxic. Now my fucking Tapu Koko's... Come on, what if I should have U-turned into Excadrill, but I then was like... Thought he would go for Rocks and I can just spin those away. Now I have to be really careful. Oh god. That's why I usually like heal by support on my balance team or bulky offense. And he goes Quagsire. That's exactly where we want U-turn and... This is like really bad, because now I'm forced into Tangrowth, I think. And I don't have anything to pressure his Chansey, because he toxic me. If he didn't toxic me, I could double around and stuff. I just go to his Tangrowth and click knockoff. There you go, Skarmory. We get rid of the leftovers, which is something, and we will just go drill because I will never have, I will not let him get rocks up or something like that. Because I ain't having that. I don't have. I'm not playing with a stall with rocks on my side. Nope. Okay, Spike. I mean, I wish I had rocks on this drill now. Because it would be amazing to get those up. Let me just spin, spam spin. Pretty boring to watch. Switch out, dude, switch out. This is too boring. You don't want to spam rocks and spikes for 5 hours. Yeah, let me think how I could have played the last game differently. Magina is honestly just a big threat to this team because my Tangrowth took damage because I like used it for the Gyarados. Then like I don't think I could have done anything about this Magina. We'll just go Volcanion on this. If he U-turns, he gets... No, I'm going Scizor. If he U-turns, he gets a free chance. I'm not letting that happen. And he takes... Oh god, knockoff, okay. I mean, some chip on Scizor is nice and I can get my rocks up. And I can U-turn on this. Just in the drill, because I don't want rocks on my side. Pretty, like, pretty boring, honestly. Like, this is so boring. I hope I can pull off the win. But this is just not fun. But as long as I can keep rocks on his side and, like, keep them away on my side, I'm in a decent position. I'll just keep going Landorus, I guess. No, Vulcanion. Vulcanion is a better play. There's no way he knocks off again. He just roosts. And I have to double now on his Chansey. Which I will do by going to Tangrowth, because I don't have anything else to pressure Chansey. If my Coco wasn't poisoned, I would go to Coco and just taunt. But I ain't having that. And if I go to Tangrowth, I can, like, at least knock off his Chansey. Yeah, Guardian of Alola would have been amazing this game. Like, people told me, like, Nature's in my on Skype, that in the Skype Pokemon chat, Nature's Madness beats Chansey anyway, but Guardian of Alola, look, he would have been at, like, 25%, so after Roxy would have been at 13 or 12, so, yeah, I could just, like, beat it with everything. I think Guardian of Alola is a bit better to beat Chansey, but in other scenarios, Nature's Madness is fine, obviously. So, yeah, I don't know why this guy's taking his return. Let me pause it for him. This is just annoying. Move, stall faggot, move. So yeah, he finally made this move and we got the Chansey. And yeah, I have to knock off here. Said that I had to let him heal. What do I even do with this thing? Like earthquake once, that does nothing. Going Landorus and U-turning around seems fine. I should have done that. No, I don't want my Landorus toxic. This is fine. I can just U-turn here. If he goes Skarmory, I have a free U-turn with my Coco. I'm not free because I take toxic, but free as in I pressure him because he cannot stay in. I mean, I can go to Volcanion too. But I'd rather go to Coco and U-turn. If he stays in here, that's really annoying for me, but he should go to Quagsire. As long as I can keep Roxas and double around, I'm in a good position. I can go to Tangrowth here and I can predict Chansey or what else could come in. Chansey or Tentacruel. Chansey slash Tentacruel, so double back into Landorus. Should be fine. As he stayed in for some reason, I think. Never mind, Tangrowth is just faster than. Wait. He went into Skarmory? Okay, that made sense because he wants to get rocks up. Should have thought about that longer. I thought he would go do something else. Gosh. Like, this just makes me not want to play Pokemon anymore. I don't have anything to click, but I have to stay in with my drill because I cannot let him, like, get rocks up. It's just really annoying. Ah, nice triple flinch. I hope we can, like, flinch him down completely. Nice Jirachi. I mean, we won't be able to. He will just roost soon. What the fuck? I flinched him 4 times in a row. I mean, that's nice, because now he's kind of forced to roost. And I can, like, switch here. In the Volcanion. So he shouldn't stay in. He should go Chansey. Or Tentacruel, which means going Landorus should be fine. Okay, nice. And now I can U-turn out. Because I don't want my Landorus to get poisoned. And I also don't want him to go Skarmory, exactly. And I can go to Volcanion here, or yeah, exactly. The thing is, I have to double again because there's a Chansey. If he stays in, I'm in a bad position, but I have to keep doing this. Amazing. Next, I will just U-turn one more time, breaking this gamma because he cannot afford to stay in. And this time I will just attack, because I have been doubling around for a while. This guy's feeling the pressure. I will just go for steam eruption this time, because I feel like he will stay in eventually. That's how I play when I use stall. If they double around, I will eventually just stay and predict them in the double again. Because if they keep predicting me and I stay in, I just lose. That's why I feel like he will just stay in and go for Roxy or something like that. Okay, never mind. Okay, I should have doubled once more. Can I please get a burn? That's a good chunk. If I was Specs, this thing would get blown away. I mean, yeah, that was annoying. But I just had a feeling that he would stay in at one point. But that was the wrong turn, I guess. Was watching Zamrock's live earlier and he'd like doubled around a lot too when he had rocks up. So I should have just kept doing it, I guess. Let me pause before this guy's taking forever. If he stays in, what does he have? Seismic Toss or Toxic? I'm gonna go to Drill here predicting a Toxic. He goes for Seismic Toss. Can just fire off Iron Heads here. Ghost Scissor, okay. I guess Earthquake was better. Scissor gets a U-turn. Actually, it doesn't have U-turn, okay. Let's just go Lando then. I don't want to go Volcano and lose my lefties. Lefties are kind of nice. He has SD. Okay, Volcano was the better play then. Volcano was the better play every day of the week. Rip my life, this is gonna blow me away now. Yeah, I did a shit ton, and now he should go into Chansey. So I just go Landris. If he stays in now, in a bad position, but he shouldn't. No, let's just click Fire Blast, whatever. He's at plus one, he might just say. Okay, never mind. Hopefully the cancel button didn't work. Rip. That's it a lot if I just burn or crit him once. If I just burn him or crit him or something, which I don't, this would be amazing. I shouldn't play like this, but I'm getting tired. Ah, nice burn, that's what I was going for. No, I mean, he has natural cure, but yeah, this team is still too weak to Chansey. Like I said, Ferium Z Tapu Koko would be amazing. I will change it to that. Or Tapu Neum, or however it's called. Yeah, let's just U-turn. I thought he would not stay in because he has to go Skarmory kinda. Because this Earthquake would do like a shit ton to this. Since he's not. Doesn't have enough Violet. And since he's like burned, I thought he would just switch to get the natural Q. So now it's gonna go Scissor or Skarm. So we just go back Volcanion to cover both options. Exactly, and now we just double back, predicting him to go Chansey. We just go back Lando. Oh, he goes Tentacruel. I think I will just click Earthquake this time, because I've been doubling around for ages. I will just click Earthquake. Exactly, he tries to spin, he loses his Tentacruel. I can get my rocks back up later on, and we made some progress now. We are turn 36, finally Mon down. I know this might not be like too interesting to watch for you guys, but I have to. This is what we all have to deal with here sometimes. I mean, stall on the ladder. I don't think his stall team is good at all. His stall team is really weird. Looks like some old Aura's shit version that's kinda loses. Actually, doesn't lose to Zydex. Hit a quick sir. I feel like he's forced to roost here, so I'm still forced to go into Volcanion because there's another threat. Now he has a free Chansey in the back, so I'm gonna go to Drill here and get my rocks back up on the Chansey. I mean, I should play like that, I don't let the Chansey heal, but since my Tapu Koko is poisoned, that's gonna be tough. Because if he predicts me to taunt and goes for a Seismic Toss, my Tapu Koko is almost dead. Like, I cannot afford to make that play. I don't think I can. Did he stay? I'm gonna be pissed. Okay, he goes Chansey as a expected in Wilderness. Oh, I don't have rocks on this. RIP. I should have gone to Landorus. Why did I think I had rocks on this? RIP. Because when I first built the team, I had rocks on this. That's why I saw that. So let's just go Landorus now. Quagsire is annoying, but I have to get rocks up to pressure him, so I'm gonna go for that. I hope I don't get Skull Burned if he goes for that. Actually, Volcanion would have been a good play. Okay, Toxic predicting that, because he didn't want to go for Skull, giving me the health. But yeah, now rocks are here to stay. But a few of my mounts are poison. My Volcanion lost its lefties. This is not looking too well, but I mean, it's looking good. I just have to play well now. And this guy's so annoying. Like, you have using fucking stall, like, move. I know there are some turns that you have to think when you use stall, but at the moment there's not much to think about. He just toxics again here, probably. I mean, I have a free tank growth here, not much to think about, and I will just double out next turn. He predicted my Volcanion, I'm not that stupid, dude. So he's either going Chansey, Scizor, or Skarmory here. I mean, he could go Clef too, but he shouldn't go Clef. Volcanion covers like both. Covers two of the three options, so I'm gonna make that play. Exactly. And I will just Steam Eruption. Since if he goes to Chansey, at least he's forced to like spam Soft Build, and I should have doubled that. Actually would have been amazing, but we get a crit and a burn. Let's go. Not sure if Off Power kills. Slash Wave should kill from 6% since he lost the valet. Yeah, I think now we got it. That's how you beat Stall, folks. I mean, that was his team was bad, but my team wasn't even that good versus Stall, honestly. If you had a Sableye to keep rocks off. Oh yeah, that's the reason I run rocks on Mold Breaker Drill. So I get rocks up versus Sableye, so I might just change it back, put rocks on drill. But Landorus is a more reliable rocker in my opinion. That's why I change it to rocks. Landorus drill doesn't get rocks off reliable versus offense in my opinion. And it's already like annoying that you have to spin and stuff. So he might predict me to double here, but this guy hasn't been making any plays. Since his Chansey is dead now, Scizor is the only huge threat. I have to be really careful that I don't lose to Scizor. I will just leave Storm here, because yeah, I thought he might stay in since I have been doubling around. And that just got into his mind. I mean, I played this decently well, but honestly, his stall damage is bad, like I already said. And I'm just forced to go Hard Volcanion. This is the biggest threat to my team, good god. And I just have to hit his Fire Blast here. If I miss, I potentially lose, but yeah, we hit amazing. And yeah, there's no way we lose this now. I'm kind of happy how I played this. Nice 44 minute life, 43 minute and a bit, because shoutouts to the stall faggot. We stay beating this stall faggot. Thank you guys for watching. Leave suggestions down below. This team actually like kind of needs some work. But yeah, I wasn't expecting that this was like the best team ever. Since I build it in a few minutes, which I do with a lot of teams, and I just test them afterwards, see what I'm weak to, change something. But in this meta, like I said, so many things around Z moves, Megas, we are getting Mega Mawa and Beedrill soon, there's even gonna be more to think about. You cannot check everything, obviously. I hope you guys still enjoyed. Smash that like button if you want to see more Showdown lives. And Nihilego the God, I think it came through in the first two games. And yeah, the third game I mispredicted because I thought it was Z-move Gera, but yeah, I already mentioned that. Espeel gonna start. Espeel gonna start soon as my dude Petlop BM'd me. Gonna start soon again. I think on Monday is the Espeel week 5, so most matches are around the weekend, so expect more content then. Other than that, expect me to start streaming. If I get like 50 followers, you just have to follow me. Twitch link is in the description. And I'm Dr. James signing out. I hope you guys all enjoyed. I might leave a page of this team, not sure. Just ask me if you want a team. I'm too lazy to, like, I will probably forget to make a paste. Dr. James out. Peace, friends.